This video is going to look at proving the Pythagorean theorem using Starburst candies. As you can see, we've got a right triangle here, and one side or one leg we're going to represent using pink Starburst, and that is 3 Starbursts long, or a total of 9 Starbursts total on that square. The other leg is represented using yellow Starburst, and you can see that that is 4 Starbursts long. And then the hypotenuse, or that one that's diagonal, that is represented using orange Starburst, and that is 5 Starbursts long. Now you can see that we've made squares on each of the 2 legs and the hypotenuse, and on the leg with the pink Starburst, there are 9. On the leg with the yellow Starburst, there are 16, and on the hypotenuse square, there are 25 candies. Next, we're going to take all of these candies from the pink square and the yellow square and see if all of these candies together are enough to make up the square of the hypotenuse. So we're plugging them all in. And what do you know? The pink area plus the yellow area is the same as the area of the hypotenuse. So let's take a look at exactly what we saw here in that last video with the Starburst. So you'll see that the pink square, remember, we said was 3 Starbursts long, the yellow square was 4 Starbursts long, and then that hypotenuse was 5 Starbursts long. Likewise, we realized that the area of the pink square was 9 Starbursts, the area of the yellow square was 16 Starbursts, and the area of the red square was 25 Starbursts. So we can see that when we added the pink Starburst plus the yellow Starburst, we actually got 25, the amount of the red Starburst. So if we square the leg of one side of the triangle and we add the square of the leg of the other side of the triangle, we're going to get the square of the hypotenuse, which is 25. If we take the square root of 25, we are going to end up with the actual side of the hypotenuse. Now let's take a look at these in terms of your homework. If you take a look at this question here, you will see that they have really nicely laid out our squares on our 2 legs and our hypotenuse. So I see that one leg of my triangle is 22. So in order to find the area of this whole square, I'm going to do 22 times 22, which is 484. That is going to go in that box right there. On the other side, I see that my next leg is 23. So again, to find the area of this whole square, I'm going to say 23 times 23, which is 529. That is going to go in that box there. Now, I know that if I add these two together, in other words, if I add the area of the squares of my 2 legs together, I am going to get the area for this larger square that is on my hypotenuse. So 484 plus 529, let me go ahead and do that here. I'm going to get 1013. That is going to go in that box right there. Now, in order to figure out what my side of my hypotenuse is, let me change colors here. If I want to know what the side, just this side right here is, I need to take the square root of 1013. So, using my calculator, the square root of 1013 is actually a decimal, 31.827. Now I look and my question says to round my answer to the nearest hundredth. So because I need to round to the nearest hundredth, I know that the 2 is in the hundredths place. I'm going to look at the 7 and decide if it's closer to 2/100ths or 3/100ths? Well, I know that it's going to be closer to 3/100ths. So my answer for the side of this hypotenuse is going to be 31 83/100ths or 31.83. On this last problem, I see that they have given me a problem without my square. So I can think of this as my squares being attached. Now I'm going to draw terrible squares, but you're getting the picture here, okay? So I noticed that they've given me one leg, which is 14. So I'm going to go ahead and square 14 in order to find this area. 14 times 14, if I use my calculator, which you should be doing now, is going to be 196. So my area for that square is 196. Next, I see that my side leg here is 8. So 8 squared is going to be 64. That's going to go in that box there. Then again, I know that if I add the area of this square with the area of the square of my other leg, I'm going to end up with the area of the square of my hypotenuse. So 64 plus 196 gives me an area of 260. Again, to find the actual side of my hypotenuse there, I need to take the square root of 260. You're definitely going to want to use your calculator for this. The square root of 260 comes out to 16.124. Again, it tells me to round, and this time it actually tells me to round to the nearest tenth, so make sure you're reading the directions there. So looking at my number that's in the tenths place would be a 1. I'm going to look and see, is this closer to 1/10 or 2/10? It is closer to 1/10. So the answer that I would write in this box right here is going to be represent the side of the hypotenuse, which would be 16.1. I hope this video was helpful for the Pythagorean theorem.